For the first quarter of 2022, we reported total net revenues of $45.4 million and a net income of $29.9 million. Adjusted net income attributable to common shareholders was $26.8 million or $3.70 per share diluted. Adjusted EBITDA for the period stood at $31.1 million. We are indeed very pleased with the company's increased profitability, which is of course the result of the extremely strong charter rates our vessels recorded during the first quarter of 2022. In this positive environment and with robust earnings visibility well into 2024, we believe our stock should be trading at much higher levels, given the value of these contracted revenues and the net asset value of the company. We believe these factors combined create captivating opportunities for us. Therefore, the company's board of directors approved a share repurchase program for up to a total of $20 million of the company's common stock to be used at management's discretion. The board will review the program after a period of 12 months. Share repurchases will be made from time to time from cash in open market transactions at prevailing market prices or in privately negotiated transactions. The timing and amount of purchases under the program will be determined by management based upon market conditions and other factors. The program does not require the company to purchase any specific number or amount of shares and may be suspended or reinstated at any time in the company's discretion and without notice. At the same time, our increased profitability and charter coverage has allowed us to reinstate our common stock dividend plan, which ran consecutively from 2005 until 2013, but had to be paused due to the negative markets experienced in the last decade. This plan rewards our shareholders without having to hold back our growth strategy, as we are paying out just a small part of our contracted earnings. In this respect, our board of directors has declared a quarterly dividend of 50 cents per share for the first quarter of 2022, payable on or about June 16, 2022, to shareholders of record on June 9, 2022. Despite the short-term rewards we have initiated for our shareholders, we do remain committed to further growth of the company. We therefore continue to examine investment and other opportunities, and we expect to remain a significant participant in the feeder container ship market as we grow our fleet.